In this video, we're going to go over the process of calculating density of different items. Density is a compound measurement. It is a ratio between two values, mass and volume. Something that is very dense will have a high mass, even with a small volume. Things that are not very dense require a large amount of that substance in order to be considered heavy. 1 kilogram of lead and 1 kilogram of feathers have the same mass, but would have very different volumes. Before your next step, make a hypothesis as to which you think is more dense, vegetable oil or water. Record that hypothesis in your lab worksheet. If you have two substances that do not mix, and at least one of them is a liquid or a gas, they will separate out from each other based on their density. The substance that is more dense will sink or be on the bottom, and the other substance will float. And you've seen this in the case of ice cubes floating in a glass of water. Ice is slightly less dense than water, and so it will float. In this activity, we are going to calculate the density of two liquids. To calculate density, you need two measurements, the mass of the item and also its volume. The units that we'll be using to calculate density will be grams for mass and milliliters for volume. The first step is to get measuring cups, one for oil and one for water. Before we start measuring the liquids, we need to know what the mass of the empty cups are. And so you'll place that empty cup on your scale or balance and record the mass of the empty cup in grams. You will then use those medicine cups as a measuring tool to measure out specific volumes of our two liquids of interest. We'll want to measure out 25 mils of water in one of the medicine cups and 30 mils of oil in the other. We will now take these filled cups and get another mass measurement of the filled cup. To determine the mass of the liquids, we need to subtract the weight of the empty cup from the weight of the filled cup. It turns out we don't really care about the cup itself, but we need that cup in order to measure the volume of liquid we're interested in. We can't simply pour the oil or the water onto the scale or balance to get a mass measurement and then get all of that back for the next steps of our experiment. So the cup is there both to measure the volume of the liquid and also to hold it contained in order to get the mass. Now that we have our two measurements, the volume as measured by the medicine cup and the mass, which is the difference between the filled cup and the empty cup, we can now calculate the density for these two liquids. The formula for calculating density is mass over volume, and the units for density are grams over mils. Once we have our calculation of density, the next step of this experiment will be to combine the two liquids together in another cup to see how they interact with each other. What do you expect would happen? Does it match your original hypothesis? And can you use this information to further your hypothesis in any way? That's all for this activity.